Suppose if you want to change the directory, in the previous slide you have seen like I am in this at the CDAC directory, right? So I want to change my directory. So what is the command I have to use here? What is the command I have to use here? So I have to use the CD. Basically, CD stands for changing the directory. Why changing the directory required is basically compared to your Windows operating system. So suppose if you want to install any softwares through terminal mode or through from CLI mode, you cannot directly install by sitting into the desktop. Suppose your file is there in the slash opt or slash slash home slash cdac and slash tie-up. Tie-up is the one of the user. And tie-up ke andar you have a file with name as tst.dev, some kind of software which need to be installed. But you are in tie-up to user. So for that purpose, you have to change the directory. You have to switch user into the another user, and then you have to execute. But the beautification of Linux is you can install either through CLI or either through your GUI mode also. Okay. Suppose there is a dev package which is already there in the location, you have to go to directly to that location. Right-click it and install through the Debian package manager. Okay, but there are some. But if you want to really do with your, if you want to make your hands free using the commands, so you have to go to that particular directory and you have to execute by going to that particular directory. Okay, so what is the command? Hash cd. Okay, so it gives you the privilege to change the directory. See here, here is the one of the example. Where my previous directory was CDAC. Okay, so then what I have done is I have downloaded some kind of dot Debian, because why I am stressing here Debian is presently I took an example of the Ubuntu Linux which is an Debian dot Debian format. Okay, so what I have done is like I have installed I have downloaded the same package in my documents. Okay, because I don't want to show to all members, so I have hidden all the content into the documents. Then so hash cd space doc. So doc, you can give doc and hit and just give the button tab, so it will auto forward you and it will give the documents structure. Or you can type cd space documents, then hit enter, then see your directory is changed to the documents, right? So what is your present directory now? Under root, under cdac, you have a documents, right? So can you tell me what is your present directory here in your case? Can anyone can from the tell from the experts? Neha Yadav, Alok, Varma ji, can anyone can tell what is my present directory? Because the next slides will tell like what is my present directory. Srinivas or someone else can tell me like what is my present directory when I am using here. It's a documents, right? Yeah, perfect. So suppose I am in present directory in the documents. Yeah, home cdac documents, correct. Suppose if I want to list the documents file, what is the command I have to use? Suppose if I want to view. Yes, ls hyphen la. Yeah, ls, correct. So coming to the next thing, correct. Yeah, correct. So this is my present working directory. Okay, suppose if I want to see where exactly I am located, where exactly my directory is located. So what is the command that is? So you have to type hash pwd. Pwd is nothing but your present working directory. Okay, it prints your current working directory. So can you tell me like from the previous screen, what is your present working directory here? What is your present working directory here? No, tell me the full path. Slash. Yes, slash home. Whether it is a slash home or a slash root. Slash root. Yeah, slash home. CDAC and the documents. Correct. Yes, it's a root. It's a pw slash root slash cdac. Yeah, perfect. So under the root cdac documents, So you are in this present work, present directory, right? So, yeah, correct. But in case of my here, I am in home CDAC documents, right? So some of the members told like I am in root CDAC documents. Why like that? So presently my working directory is slash home because under the root, because I already told like the root is the head of the family. Okay, under root you have a home. That means for entire file structure, the head of the family is root. Under the root you have a home. Under the home you have a CDAC. Under the CDAC you have number of files and folders, right? So present working directory in my case, as per my requirements, I change to the slash home slash CDAC slash documents, right? So present working directory is home CDAC and documents. When you go to the root CDAC documents also, it will be prompted you to the home only, okay? Because you are already in root only, okay? So suppose coming to the next slide, so you want to make a directory. If you want to create a directory, so suppose in case of Windows, how you create a directory? Right click, folder, text file, or any file, right? Right click on the desktop. So you will create a file or folder or desktop or documents or whatever it may be, right? But in case of your Linux, suppose that too, there are two options are there in Linux. One you can do through Linux, through command line interface, where I'm telling about these commands. And also there is a graphical. On the desktop, you right click it, you can create a directory. There is not like that, like compulsory you have to work in command line interface only, okay? But why I am stressing the command line interface, it is very fast compared to your GUI method. And once you start the working in your command, so you will really enjoy the commands, okay? So mkdir is will allow you to create a directories. And the example is like mkdir. Can Uma Shankar ji, can you please tell me like how to create a directory with name Uma Shankar under my terminal? Uma Shankar or Naveen, please type your directory name followed by your name. No, MK Naveen, no, MKDR Naveen, MK, yeah, perfect. MKDR Naveen. So what about others? Suppose, can you create a directory with name Tayyab? Can you create a directory with Tayyab? Can you just show me the example of, yeah. Perfect. So I think you got an idea, right? So how to create a directory. These are the directories you can create using a command as well as your, through your, what we say like a GUI method also, okay? Yeah. So I think you got a basic idea how to create a directories. Yeah, so perfect. Yeah, so make a directory Tayyab. So as usual, so you can also list a file. Okay, there are some n number of, suppose after creating a directory, the directory Tayyab or as per your names, so you should always see, right, whether it is created or not. So what is the command? You can always use a ls command as we discussed in the first slide, right? So I think till morning you have seen like introduction to Windows and what are the various flavors of Windows and how this evolution and history of Windows and what are the basic difference between Windows and Linux. So now we will see like what is the introduction to the Linux operating systems. Okay, so I think the Linux operating system is secure as compared to the Windows operating system, right? So basically it has the ext4 file systems and compared to the Windows operating systems, it has all different file systems and the different hierarchies. And so we'll just go to the basic levels of the introduction to the Linux systems and how we can configure. Suppose if you are configuring any Linux operating systems and different file structures and all those things, then later we'll go with Windows hardening as well as the Linux hardening. Okay, just we will have some overview of the Linux operating systems, right? I think how many members have the basic idea about the Linux operating systems? So how many members have the dual boot operating systems, and how many members have the Linux operating system with respect to this Oracle VirtualBox or VMware or anything? So any idea about the Linux operating system? So what kind of, yes, Raju, I think you told us. So what is the flavor you use in your Linux operating system? Dual boot, yeah, perfect, Vijay. Yeah, CentOS, okay. So whether you use a dual boot or it's an like kind of virtualization software, and inside the Windows 10 or Windows 8, you install this Linux operating system. Yeah, Ubuntu 20, Neha. Ubuntu 20. So it's a 20.0.LTS. Yes, we have the dedicated Linux virtual box. Okay, bare metal. Yeah, I think you have the basic idea about the Linux operating systems, and also you have the basic idea about the virtualizations. Okay, so any idea about like how to harden your virtual box? How to harden your Linux box? So we'll see like in detail like how to harden your different flavors of Windows and different flavors of Linux. Okay, so today we'll be discussing more on the Windows operating system hardening and also Linux operating, but basically we'll go some basic kind of Linux operating system. Yeah. So basically installation can be done in two ways. One is like you can download the ISO file from the ubuntu.com. I am taking as a Ubuntu. Okay, Ubuntu is one of the flavor which having a Debian flavor. Okay, which accepts a Debian package format. Okay, so first of all, what I have to do, suppose if I want to download a Ubuntu Linux, so like what exactly I have to, whether I have to go to the website, genuine website, that to ubuntu.com, and where I have to check my SHA level and MD5 hash algorithms. So if it is okay, then I have to go to the downloads, and then I have to download a ISO file. So without downloading ISO file, so I can also install the OS, right? So how it is possible? There are some kind of third party websites are there, third party softwares are there through which you can burn the image on the DVD. So next thing is like once you've done the ISO image download, so you have to burn the image on the DVD. Okay, so simply downloading the ISO file and you cannot install the OS on your system or laptop or server. Okay, so first of all, you have to convert those thing into the bootable media. Okay, so once you're done with the bootable media with any burning softwares. Okay, so there are a lot of ISO burning images formats are there. So one is Nero, and one is your CD Burner XP, through which you can convert your .iso into the bootable iOS files. Okay, so once you done the image, burn the image on the DVD or CD, whatever the format is, so you have to insert the DVD in the media. Okay, in the media of your PC or server, whatever it may be. So I think you have to change your BIOS mode, right? So how you can change your BIOS mode of your PC? Is it the same thing you have to keep, press the key, or are there any different formats are there? Like suppose if I restart my PC, right? So when I just keep my CD and I have to install this operating system in my laptop, right? So whether it will be automatic installation will be happen, or I have to change my boot order? Can anyone can tell from the chat box? Can anyone can tell in the chat? Suppose I kept a DVD in the drive. So what is the key I have to press in my laptop or desktop or workstation to take my DVD into the bootable format? Escape, okay. So Alok Verma ji has told escape button. So what else, like there are like different buttons are there that depends upon your manufacturer, right? You have to press F2 or F12. Yeah, so delete button, F8, that depends upon your hardware, right? So it depends upon your hardware, but basically F2 will works. F2 and your basically escape will works, and it shows you the BIOS mode. Okay, so where exactly what you have to do means you have to change your priority, boot priority, because there are two to three options are there. One is you have to boot your DVD or CD into the using your bootable disk. That is nothing but your DVD drive. Okay. Second thing is like there is some other option, like you have to boot your DVD into from the hard disk. Okay.